When you see Journey Smollett and the likes of Lovecraft Country and Birds of Prey, you probably don't even realize you're watching a grown-up Denise from Full House. So let's take a tour through her resume to see how she went from child star to industry vet. When you consider Journey Smollett's family background, it makes total sense that she was such a natural on Full House. She's the fourth of six kids, who have all been involved in the performing arts at some point in their lives. Just like the Full House clan, the Smollett siblings have been incredibly close throughout their whole lives. Her older brother Jesse told the New York Times that the family affectionately refers to themselves as Small Nation, because they have their very own culture. As Jesse recalled of his sister to the Times, at a year old, she was like a mix of Diana Ross and Elizabeth Taylor. She was boss from the beginning.
What kind?
Sour cream and onion.
Really? Sure. What would I like about potato chips?
In 1994, all six of the Smollett siblings teamed up for their very own sitcom called On Our Own. Airing for one season on ABC, it starred the real-life brothers and sisters as a family who lose their parents and are then raised by their big brother. And Journey's not the only Smollett who's gone on to adult stardom. Jesse, for one, played Jamal Lyon on Fox's hip-hop soap opera Empire until he was written out of the show. Not all of the Smollett kids have remained in showbiz, but they all remain close and help each other with their careers whenever they can. Journey and Jesse run a production company alongside their sister Jazz, and the siblings later banded together to support their brother Jake on the Food Network show Smollett Eats. As Journey told the New York Post of the show, "It's really like a sneak peek into what we like to do as a family. Food is such a centerpiece of our lives." Journey Smollett's child stardom wasn't limited to the small screen. By the age of 10, she was wowing movie audiences with her turn as the title character in the Southern Gothic drama Eve's Bayou. Starring alongside such luminaries as Samuel L. Jackson and Lynn Whitfield as her parents, she clearly made a huge impression on her castmates. Her on-screen aunt Debbie Morgan told the New York Times, "With a part like Eve, it had to be an exceptional child. It was something innate that Journey did up there on that screen. You can't teach that.
I want him dead."
While all of the adults around her were impressed with her performance, it was just a day's work for the precocious Smollett. As she told the New York Times at the time, "My agent called and told my mommy about this movie that she thought was really good for me. She said Eve was me. So my mommy and me and my sister read the script and we talked about Eve and how I should portray her and what Eve was about." As with many things in her life, Eve's Bayou was a family affair for Smollett, as her real-life younger brother Jake played her on-screen brother Poe. While Journey Smollett enjoyed well-rounded roles when she was a child star, she found it increasingly difficult to find satisfying parts as she grew into adulthood. Like many women in the industry, she became frustrated with being typecast as a mere accessory to a male-centric storyline. As she told BuzzFeed in 2016, "It's been about finding roles that weren't set dressing, characters who weren't just the girlfriend. You don't want to be the earpiece for his problems where you have to help push the plot forward. And your identity is directly connected to your male counterpart's storyline. You have no arc of your own and you're really irrelevant." Despite those struggles, Smollett continued to work steadily. During her 20s, she starred in such notable movies as the Denzel Washington-directed The Great Debaters in 2007 and Tyler Perry's Temptation, Confessions of a Marriage Counselor in 2013. And in 2016, she appeared in the sports biopic Hands of Stone alongside the likes of Usher and Robert De Niro. Although Smollett has had plenty of silver screen success, she's really stamped her name on the industry as a TV star, even though she had doubts about that career path. As she explained to BuzzFeed in 2016, "I did guest spots here and there, but I had a rule where I said, no, I'm not doing television." But she later changed her mind because, as she explained, "They're just writing more complex women in television." One of those complex women that Smollett played was high school student Jess Merriweather on the football drama Friday Night Lights. In typical Smollett fashion, her own family history informed the part. As she told GQ in 2010, "My siblings and I used to play touch football, where you put the little rag in your pocket. Smollett has appeared in other celebrated TV shows, like HBO's Supernatural True Blood, the NBC drama Parenthood, and WGN's period piece Underground, which tells the story of the Underground Railroad. When she's not busy making movies and TV shows, Smollett manages to slot a hefty amount of charity work and activism into her schedule. She inherited her passion for standing up for what she believes in from her mother Janet, who was active in the civil rights movement. As Jussie Smollett revealed to The New York Times in 2013, "My mom was in the movement with Bobby Seale and Huey Newton, and one of her first mentors was Julian Bond."
The thing that my mom raised us to believe is, you do the work that no one sees.
Although Journey values her activism, she admits that it can be hard to square her robust morals with some of the roles that she's offered. As she put it to The New York Times, "It makes it hard to just be an actor and to sell your soul, because you have this conscience. I think that's why I say no to projects, that's why Jussie says no to projects, and that's why we fight for the ones that we're told no to." In October 2010, Journey Smollett married Canadian-born musician Josiah Bell in an intimate ceremony at a Los Angeles botanical garden. Smollett decided to hyphenate her last name to Smollett Bell after marrying, and she credited the success of her relationship to the fact that she and Bell were friends before they realized they had a romantic connection. As she told The Hollywood Reporter in 2013, "We were best friends before we started even dating, so we had this really great foundation. I think one of the challenging things about any lasting relationship is that you have to be so vulnerable. I think as human beings, we try to hide our flaws and try to present this perfect person. This person we wish we were to our spouse, when that causes so many troubles." In 2016, Smollett and Bell welcomed a baby named Hunter Zion. She announced the little one's arrival on Instagram and has shared a few adorable snaps with her fans since his birth. Her favorite thing about motherhood is the way that her son helps her see the world afresh. As she told People magazine, "He's teaching me so much about myself. He's teaching me so much about love. I see myself in him and I start to love that about myself even more. It's like I see the world differently now, through his eyes. He makes me reassess really what matters." Family life isn't always easy, and Journey Smollett knows that perhaps better than anyone. In 2020, she filed for divorce from Josiah Bell after a decade of marriage. The couple had separated quietly the year before, with Smollett noting to The Hollywood Reporter that she was happy to spend some quality time with her son during the pandemic lockdown. Smollett has also had to deal with the aftermath of her brother Jussie being accused of staging an attack on himself. She's talked about how difficult it was not to be able to publicly defend her brother from something she's convinced he could never have done. As she told The Hollywood Reporter, "I look at him sometimes and I'm like, he's so strong." She also revealed that Jussie moved in with her in the wake of her divorce, and that he was staying busy with creative pursuits and had the full support of his family. Journey Smollett just knew she had to play Black Canary in 2020's Birds of Prey. The character's superpower allows her to, quite literally, take on anyone with the strength of her own voice. She was such a huge fan of the character that she used Black Canary's avatar whenever she played video games. She had given birth shortly before filming on the movie began, but she nevertheless threw herself into training multiple times a week. As she admitted to Marie Claire, "I lived in a constant state of pain." Smollett understood the importance of taking on this part, not just to herself, but to all the little girls watching, and so she committed to playing it truthfully. As she explained to Marie Claire, "In the film, we're meeting Black Canary before she actually becomes Black Canary, in the sense that she hasn't really owned her power. She's struggling with the gift she has. She struggles with the fact that she has a gift that she doesn't want to own. To me, that's something I can honestly just relate to. I think we all can."
I mean, we were amazing there!
Yeah! Hell yeah!
Smollett is picky about her roles, preferring quality over quantity, and only taking on work that truly speaks to her as an artist. In the case of the HBO horror fantasy series Lovecraft Country, set during the 1950s and loosely based on H.P. Lovecraft's many horrifying creations, this was more than just a job for Smollett. She has frequently felt left out of genre fare because of her race, and she saw Lovecraft Country as an opportunity to reclaim some of that power. as she described it to Harper's Bazaar. Seeing black folks swim and dance and fight off demons and participate in magic, it's an honor to be a part of something that feels so disruptive.
The roles you're offered as a black woman are so dismissive and not really central to the plot.
Smollett considers Lovecraft Country's fantastical retelling of history protest art. As she explained, "We're just telling the truth. The unfortunate truth is that as a nation, the systemic racism that this nation has been built upon has yet to be dismantled." Smollett also discussed the show with Deadline, as she described the removal of black voices in art as a disease. She also said, "As an artist, if you can be one more notch that contributes to painting a fuller picture of who we are, it's food for your soul." Actors are often expected to be chameleons on screen, and luckily for Journey Smollett, she's happy to shed her outer skin to bring a role to life. Her character of Letty on Lovecraft Country is someone whose appearance means a lot to her, from her chic bob to the pop of her red pout and matching nails. As the actress noted to Vogue, "There's something very dangerous about her claws, as I call them." Simply put, Smollett was eager to embody Letty as sincerely as possible. When the director of the pilot episode asked her to chop off her own locks, she was only too happy to oblige, as she admitted, "I was looking for an excuse to cut off my hair anyway." Plenty of time and effort went into creating the perfect bob for Letty, with mood boards created that included icons like Elizabeth Taylor, Eartha Kitt, and Lena Horne. As Smollett explained, "In a time and era when the erasure of black folks was so prevalent, Letty is going to be seen. She is going to stake her claim." Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about your favorite stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.